It has come down to this. The lives of these two men have intertwined for more than a year over the world title. An edge that scavenger taking the world championship from The Undertaker last May, and the battle is in full sense. And The Undertaker looking to use the power game early on. Again, Mick, the rules. Tables, ladders, and chairs can be used as weapons, but you also need the ladder to set it up in the middle of the ring to get to the world title. Well, when you unhook it, you become champion.
Well, you sure do. We just saw Undertaker landing some heavy bombs to the midsection and the ribs of Edge, and I'll tell you, it'd be very tough to climb that ladder with broken ribs. Tough to do anything.
Undertaker perhaps looking to put Edge away early because of Edge's experience in these matches, Mick.
Well, he's not likely to put him away with any one power move. In some ways, this is like the stretcher match. You need to incapacitate your opponent to the point where you can bring that ladder inside and start that long climb to the top.
Undertaker has never been in a table, ladders, and chairs match before, but we've talked about the adaptation and evolution of this man. Ooh, and if he ever needs to evolve, it is here tonight with the world title and his career on the line.
Well, The Undertaker has learned how not only to survive, but to thrive in so many situations. He's actually become the standard bearer of so many great matches, whether it be the Buried Alive match or the Hell in a Cell match. The Undertaker has set the bar so high, not to mention the casket match.
Undertaker going to old school early.
And this is the type of offense Undertaker needs to score with early and often to get that ladder inside the ring.
And the six-time champion, The Undertaker, looking to wear Edge down. And getting the ladder in the ring. Mick, what type of strategy do you use in this match?
I think for The Undertaker, it's simple. He is simply going to try to put the type of beating on Edge that will allow him to climb the ladder. For Edge, a guy who takes great pride in this type of match, he may try to dissect The Undertaker, may actually try to prove him.
Oh, and there's Edge! And there's that veteran instinct of Edge. He's been involved in these matches before. He knows what type of damage tables, chairs, and, well, as he saw, ladders can do.
And in some ways, this is like a stretcher match, because I mentioned earlier, the stretcher was not only a means of transportation, it could be used as a weapon as well. In this match, the ladder is not only a climbing apparatus, it's a way to inflict real punishment.
And Edge, involved in so many of these, knows how to inflict punishment in TLC matches, and Edge setting the table, so to speak. Undertaker.
Lying in wait,
it seems. Ladder used as a weapon again.
And sometimes the shenanigans of Edge and La Familia overshadows the fact that this is an incredible athlete, a man of intense pride. Watch his shoulder. And I know it would mean so much to Edge, not only to win this match and to recapture the World Heavyweight Championship, but to be the man who put The Undertaker away forever.
Well, it's ironic, Mick, that Vicky Guerrero did not award The Undertaker the title back at Judgment Day, because she said it must be won by pinfall or submission. Yet she makes this matchup tonight that doesn't involve pinfall or submission.
Right, but as is the case with Vicky Guerrero, so many times she makes great matches for the worst reasons. Maybe this match doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but it's going to be dramatic, and someone's going to get hurt.
Well, Edge had set the table for two, and Undertaker apparently setting it for four.
And who knows what's going through the mind of the dead man. He's so much a part, he's so firmly entrenched in the fabric of WWE that I dread to think of what this place would be like without him.
Well, you may find out. If Undertaker cannot win this match, he'll be gone forever. Undertaker methodically taking his time, and it may have cost him.
Good job, Edge. Good job, baby.
Edge the Predator.
Get up.
A scavenger at times.
You got this.
But there is no doubt the ultimate opportunist.
Now, let me bring up a point here. We've talked about the draft coming up. Now, if The Undertaker loses his match, he's excluded from the draft.
Exactly.
We're not going to see the dead man back here in a few weeks on a different show. This is do or die time for the dead man.
He's out of World Wrestling Entertainment forever. And Undertaker down and out outside the ring.
And now Edge is the first one to set up the ladder, perhaps attempting to climb.
If he climbs the ladder and grabs the world title, unhooks it, gets it down, Edge will be champion for a fifth time.
Here we
and
go,
Edge
Michael
climbing
Cole.
The ladder. Undertaker realizing the desperate times.
Called desperate measures. Edge may have momentarily forgotten about The Undertaker's capacity to absorb punishment.
Edge has committed so many crimes against The Undertaker over the past year. For The Undertaker, this was the ultimate form of punishment to win this match, Edge's match, here at One Night Stand.
Now, we can only hope that should Undertaker prevail, that somehow, some way, there'd be a new balance of power on SmackDown.
Undertaker looked like he was going for snake eyes, but he got the ladder right between his eyes. Edge with a great counter.
You know, for so many years, Edge told me he felt like this match unfairly characterized and kind of typecast him as the TLC guy and prevented him from being taken seriously as a World Heavyweight Championship contender.
How ironic is that, that he can win the title in his specialty match?
And knowing Edge the way I do, it would be sweet revenge, the most important victory in his long, storied career.
The very cunning Edge. What he's got planned here.
We can only go. Oh! He didn't plan that, Cole.
Edge skull first off the front of that ladder. And now it's Undertaker suddenly in control.
But let's not forget what I would consider Edge's very underrated capacity to absorb punishment of his own.
He's been in all these matches but one in the history of TLC. That in itself shows the amount of punishment that he can absorb.
And I guess I learned that better than anybody firsthand at WrestleMania 22.
And that hardcore match.
Where Edge just kept coming back and coming back and coming back.
Well, you also know the resilience of this man.
Yeah.
The Undertaker climbing the ladder, trying to get to the world title. Edge realizing what's at stake. Both men nearing the top of that steel. Whether it was out of strict instinct, desperation, or whatever, Edge had the wherewithal to bounce off the ladder to shift his balance and momentum and perhaps save himself the championship.
Or a combination of all three. As I mentioned, I learned firsthand how much punishment Edge could take. But the offense I could provide at WrestleMania 22 was a far cry from what the Phenom can provide, a man at the top of his game with everything to lose.
Our fans in San Diego sold out, realized what's at stake as well. The 18-year career of The Undertaker, the World Heavyweight Championship. Oh, snake eyes! Capitalized!
Well, so many in attendance here in San Diego and millions watching around the world have literally grown up with this man on Friday nights. What a profound sense of loss everyone would feel, so many would feel, should this be the last time we see him at all.
Oh. Undertaker using the ladder and his big boot as a weapon. And you kind of feel, Mick, that the momentum is shifting into the Undertaker's corner here.
A lesser man may have tried to climb once again, but Undertaker perhaps sensing that now is the time to take advantage of a weakened foe.
Well, it's about the world title, but it's also about punishing Edge for his sins.
Here's where the C in TLC.
Did you hear that?
Smacking the flesh.
Thundering across the spine.
And that is the type of blow that will just sap the strength and the will out of any opponent, even one as tough and resilient as Edge.
And you gotta wonder what's going through the mind of The Undertaker as he glances around this arena, looks at all the weapons that are available for him to use. Ooh. Edge prone. Half his body hanging over the apron as
that's just ungodly, Cole.
And look at Undertaker, 300 pounds, going for the legs, and Edge countered. Edge with the wherewithal to get the steel chair up, and I believe right under the knee of The Undertaker.
And we referred to it before as instinct on Edge's part. He knows this ring so well, he knows this match so well.
And the ultimate opportunist looks to take advantage of the opportunity. Watch Edge.
No, just in time.
Steel chair right under the back of the knee.
And Edge knows his opponent so well.
I don't think that was instinct. I think that was the cunning of Edge. Knew exactly what he was doing.
and we'll have to see how that move plays itself out here.
And now Edge, who knows the ins and outs of this match. This is where Edge becomes dangerous. He knows how to use the ladder as a weapon in every part of the arena. Uh-oh, Undertaker! Oh no!
Blatant low blow.
Legal under extreme rules. Undertaker had bad intentions. Looked like he was going for the last ride with a ladder in his sights.
And given what's at stake, you can hardly blame Edge for resorting to the blatant low blow.
Coming into this, everyone knew what the stakes were. Tables, ladders, and chairs for the world title.
Yeah, they knew the stakes, and they have never been higher.
You could hear the sickening thud of the steel chair to the Undertaker's skull. And perhaps Edge is closing in on his fifth title reign.
Edge wobbly, but walking with purpose nonetheless, after teeing off with a home run swing like they've seen at Petco Park.
We've seen the ladders used, we've seen the table, the chairs used,
watch it.
Oh, goodness! And now Edge looking to implement the tables into this matchup.
A blow like that would knock any other man out, but... That's got to be it, Cole. I believe at this point, Edge could leisurely set up a ladder and climb at his own pace.
A vicious shot from Edge. And Undertaker, who almost looked punch drunk here in front of us, just instinctively keeping his hands up.
The huge frame of the Undertaker now resting on that table.
Oh, this, the hell, what the hell is Edge doing here? No! Edge! A frog splash off the announce desk through the table.
Cole, Edge knows he needs to take these type of risks in a match with this much at stake, and that's a perfect example. Willing to damage to himself, to damage his opponent.
You take another look, the table buckling. Undertaker in deep, deep trouble. The World Heavyweight Championship hangs over the ring. And Edge setting up the ladder to try to climb for the gold.
The skull of the Undertaker was the recipient of two brutal chair shots, and now the dead man has been laid out as Edge makes his way up to championship glory.
Undertaker trying to make it back into the ring, and he does. Edge, oh, near the top of the ladder, and it's Undertaker this time. And a spear! From out of nowhere, Edge spearing the Undertaker, and is that the death knell to the Phenom?
To me, like Edge is going to use it. Oh! This ladder is an offensive weapon, maybe singling out that knee that we saw struck a few minutes ago.
And if you take the knee out, I should say, what that means is the Undertaker, well, he can't use it to climb the ladder to win the title. How are you going to climb the ladder without a knee? A concerto! A version of it. Again!
It's an excellent point, Michael. That championship is so high in the air. Either man has to take many steps to proceed up the ladder to grasp it.
You hear the Undertaker groan.
And the ultimate opportunist is a model of efficiency as he takes his time. Taking apart the Undertaker. Look at the size of that ladder, Michael.
And Edge setting it up. All he's got to do is climb to that top rung, and he'll be able to easily take the gold down. future of TLC. Edge is showing why. The Undertaker is motionless. Not another chair shot from Edge. Oh my Lord.
Well, one more of these, Michael, and his health could be in serious jeopardy.
It may already be. It's it. Undertaker set up and a little payback. And could this be the opening for the Phenom?
He's feeling out that damaged leg. Now, the Undertaker has a reservoir of guts and heart that most of us can simply not comprehend, but will it be enough to overcome the devastation that he has faced here tonight?
The resilience of the Undertaker has been storied. Undertaker with Edge on the apron! Into the ladder! Did you see the ladder buckle and bow as Edge's body cracks through it?
And it was the small of his back. All of that force concentrated on one small vital part of Edge's anatomy.
Look at Edge's body. Look at how it's twisted and
bent,
turned.
Broken.
And Undertaker, no one's going to stop the Undertaker. On one leg, he's going to try to climb the ladder. Oh, my God.
No, come on.
Hawkins and Ryder. Edge's buddies, Hawkins and Ryder.
At a moment when the Undertaker had this match won.
And a mugging. Under extreme rules, you can't do anything about it, but a mugging by Hawkins and Ryder. Just when the Undertaker was closing in on the world title.
You have to think that this was a preconceived act of cruelty here, Cole. Desperation measure to save their man from certain defeat.
Well, you saw how Edge's body was contorted after going through the ladder outside the ring. Hawkins and Ryder realized it, coming to the rescue of the man. And now, looking to damage and destroy the Phenom. And what this does, it buys Edge time to try to recuperate outside the ring. Here's the chokeslam again. And look at the body of Edge just twisting.
And Edge will need to have a lot of time bought. After that devastating impact.
What in the world? What the hell is this? That is Hawkins going to the top rope. Ryder punishing the Undertaker. What at all? Oh, Undertaker. And Hawkins didn't see Undertaker in the offensive blow.
Take a ride!
Oh! Carnage strewn through the sports arena!
But now Edge has slid in. Perhaps Ryder and Hawkins did their part.
A spear! A spear by Edge! Undertaker's bad knee crashing into that barricade, the retaining wall. And is that all Edge needs to reclaim the championship? Watch this! The height that Hawkins flew from!
Unbelievable strength and resiliency on the part of the Undertaker.
Edge, you setting the tables again in the ring. Undertaker just struggling outside the ring with a bad knee.
But I think, Michael, we simply reach a point where the boundaries of human endurance cannot be reached.
And Edge trying desperately to climb the ladder, trying to climb for the world title. Remember the punishment his body's gone through. And the chase is on. It's Edge climbing to the top of the ladder. Undertaker somehow willing his way back into the ring.
Edge is there. Time. He's 3 feet from glory here, Cole.
Edge is near the title. He's got his hands on the title. And it's Undertaker climbing the ladder as well. One leg! Oh my God!
He's gonna send him for a ride!
A last ride! A last ride! Through two tables!
Yeah! Yeah!
Rollins. Oh! And Undertaker. Undertaker was looking up at the gold when Edge crashed through the table. And now the Phenom gonna climb the ladder.
But this is where that knee injury comes in. Look, the dead man simply cannot brace on that injured knee.
But if anybody has the willpower, if anybody has the will and the way, hey! Bam! Neely and Chavo Guerrero left Familia in full force! Like a pack of angry rabid dogs, left Familia stealing the championship from The Undertaker's grasp!
And by all rights, this match should be over and we should be celebrating the championship reign of The Undertaker.
Oh, no, no! Oh! I would not want to be Bam Neely about right now! Chavo! There are bodies strewn everywhere! The Phenom has destroyed La Familia.
Single-handedly, The Undertaker has littered this ring with bodies.
Undertaker on one leg, climbing toward the world title. The Phenom, a matter of moments, moments away from recapturing the gold that was unceremoniously stripped from him.
He's on one leg.
But now he was! Oh, The Undertaker was seemingly closing on the world championship.
Just when you thought that nothing could stop The Undertaker, that unheralded ability of Edge, with the help of some friends, to withstand punishment and go on, comes into play.
Oh, no. Edge, The Undertaker is out. Edge is climbing to the world title with one watchful eye on the Phenom. But the ultimate opportunist looking to take advantage of the greatest opportunity of his career. Not only to win the world title, Edge is there! Edge is the world champion!
The winner of this match and new world heavyweight champion, the Rated R Superstar, Edge!
An absolutely stunning, startling, shocking moment.
Michael, I need to tell you, it seems as if the impossible has happened here tonight. That the man who has come to characterize everything that is good about not only SmackDown, but WWE, has seen his last moment inside a WWE ring.
The Rated R Superstar, the Master Manipulator Edge, has won the world title yet again.
But even more importantly, Michael, he has done it at the expense of the career of The Undertaker. And he did it with the help of four friends.
Here was the shocking ending. Undertaker closing out the world title. Oh. And the ultimate opportunist struck again.
Sets it up.
The Undertaker had absorbed so much punishment meant in this matchup, but he could not stand
it. Unfortunately, that's a case where The Undertaker's size and height worked against him, because the higher he got up on that ladder, the more science seemed to work against him, the easier it was for Edge to make that one dastardly attempt and come up with the heavyweight championship.
An absolute look of disbelief in the eyes of the new champion as well. And what he accomplished tonight. And there, the
and
general manager.
Cured, apparently, miraculously cured.
The general manager, the fiance of Edge, Vicky Guerrero.
Now, Edge wrestled his heart out, but the problem here, as I've said before, is the Edge, he ends just as much me.
This whole thing is totally surreal. The Rated R era beginning for a fifth time, and ladies and gentlemen,
Michael, it's a night of extremes that we will never forget, but nothing more extreme than the sense of loss I think we all feel here at knowing we've maybe seen the last, possibly the greatest WWE superstar in history.
The career of The Undertaker is dead, but his legacy will live forever.